This is the IO board, the Raspberry Pi dev board designed for the Compute Module 5. With a small SSD like this one, you've got yourself a fully capable mini computer. The CM5 mounts directly onto the socket using the edge connectors on both sides. Let's take a closer look at the main components on this IO board. This is the RDC battery socket. Next, we find two HDMI 2.0 ports supporting 4K output, an Ethernet port with PoE support, two USB 3.0 and a USB-C 2.0 port for power and programming, and a microSD card slot. Next to it, we have an M.2 socket for an NVMe SSD. So let's go ahead and connect ours. Right next to the compute module socket, we have the fan connector. These are two MIPI connectors for attaching a camera, display, or touchscreen. Between them is the power button. Here are the classic 40 GPIO pins for attaching Raspberry Pi hats and expansion modules. This set of 14 pins, along with the jumpers, lets you enable or disable certain features and connect additional peripherals. For full details, check the board's datasheet. We've included a link in the video description. These additional 4 pins, together with the 2 jumpers, allow you to manage the communication between cameras and displays connected to the CM5. These 4 J9 pins handle PoE power management. Those are all the key components on the board. So let's install our CM5 and get this setup ready to go. Although something's missing, right? Maybe it's in this box. Here we have the IO case, the official Raspberry Pi enclosure for this IO board. It's made entirely of metal, with cutouts for every connector, clearly labeled in white silkscreen. You can remove this small rubber plug in case you need to add an external antenna. Let's open it up. You'll see the two parts separate easily. In the base, we find a small bag with thermal pads and the screws needed to secure the IO board. So let's mount it in place. The top section includes a fan that creates continuous airflow to keep the board properly cooled. We plug it into the fan connector, close the case, and now the IO board is fully protected and ready for action. You'll find links in the description to the official Raspberry Pi website, where you can get more details about these products. Meanwhile, we're going to see what we can build with this setup. Any ideas? Leave your suggestions in the comments. Thanks for watching.